Hi students, now we learn fourth standard science subject lesson 1 life and survival of plant. So answer of previous session, question 1, define aquatic plants. Plants that live and grow in water are called aquatic plants. The second question, name the three types of aquatic plant. Answer number 1, floating plants, number 2, fixed plants, and number 3 is that underwater plants. The third question is that right to adapt to feature of the floating plant. The answer is that they have small and light bodies that can float. Second point is that some plants have spongy and air-filled stem, so that's why they can be easily float on the water. So it is over. You learned these three question answer yesterday. Let's start today's session. So now we learn that there are terrestrial plant, in that terrestrial plant in desert, plant in plains, plant in hills, and aquatic plants. So now we have to do an activity. So we have to select the appropriate word for the plant. For example, for the desert plant, we will write here D. For aquatic plant, we'll write A. And for plant in plain, we'll write P. So we can add here, this is the plant in plain. So we'll write here P only. And it is also plant in plain, so we will write here also same. We'll write here P also. And here, you know that Lutz is the aquatic plant, so we will write here. So we will write here A. A for aquatic plant. And last is that it is a desert plant. So what is the symbol for cactus desert plant? D. So in this way, we can understand that the plant in plains are different. The desert plants are different and aquatic plants are also different. Okay, so use this information to write in your textbook. Okay, let's see the next point. So time to answer. So there is a column A and column B we have to join. So duckweed. So duckweed is a floating plant. So I give the answer here. Lotus is a under. Lotus is that fixed plant. So answer is here. And hydrilla is a underwater plant. So check out your answers. What is in the fixed plant? You can see that this is a plant of lotus. So this plant is root is under the water. You can see that the roots is under the water, but stem, flower and leaves are above the water. So the plants have roots that are fixed bottom of the pond. So you can see that this is a pond and the plant's roots are at the bottom. But then most of the vegetation means they plant part such as stem, flower, leaves above the water. Such kind of plant is called fixed plant. So everybody understand what is in the fixed plant? The plant which has root under the water, but vegetation like stem, flowers and the leaves above the water, they are called fixed plant. So fixed plants have the special feature. So you can see that these are the fixed plant. Their roots are under the water, but their leaves and other substances are above the water, such as stem and flower. So this, they have a special body character. That's why they can be fixed in the water and their body surface above the water. First feature is that they have long, hollow, flexible stem. So you can see that this is the fixed plants. Their stem is long and hollow, that is filled with the air and flexible. Understand, the first feature of the fixed plant is that they have long, hollow and flexible stem. And second point is that you can see the leaves. So their leaves are broad and flat. How are the leaves? Broad. They are broad, white and flat. So that float on the surface of water. So you can see that the first feature of the fixed plant, they have long, hollow and flexible stem. And how are their leaves? The leaves are broad and flat, so that easily float on the surface of water. This is the first feature. And second feature is that the upper surface of their leaves have a waxy coating. Do you know this is a waxy coating? Means that does not allow the water enter. So water will stay on its surface. So you can see that this is a waxy coating on the leaves. And second is that they have stomata. So what is the function of stomata? So this is the stomata is a hole or pores on the leaves. So it is useful to absorb air. Understand? So that's why they can easily float on the water. The second feature is that the upper surface of the leaves have waxy coating and stomata is present to absorb the air. And the example of fixed plant, number one, lotus, and second is that water lily. Remember it. The next variety of plant, of aquatic plant, is that underwater plant. So you can see that this is above the water, but plants are growing under the water. The plants which grow under the water, or the plants remain completely submerged. Submerged in the water means that is sink under the water. Such plants are called underwater plants. So everybody understand what is in the underwater plant? The plants remain completely submerged or sink in the water are called underwater plants. So what are the features of underwater plant? So first of all, that they have narrow and thin leaves. So now you can see that the leaves are very narrow and thin. Okay, first point is that. And second is that they have flexible stem. The stem can be easily bent or move here and there. So this is the first feature. So that offer little resistance to the water current, means if the water flow, so they do not get opposition or resistant to it. So what is the first feature of underwater plant? Simply remember, they have narrow and thin leaves. Understand? Very, very narrow and very, very small and narrow and thin leaves. And second, they have flexible stem. So that offer the little resistance to the water current. And second feature is that they breathe through their body surface. They do not have stomata. Do you know that fixed plant have stomata, but this plant breathe through the body, means they can breathe through their leaves. They can breathe through these stems. They can breathe through the roots, means they can breathe through all the body parts and no need of stomata, means they do not have stomata. And some example of underwater plant. So do you know that the plant which grown under the water is called underwater plants? An example is that hydrilla, and second is the tape grass, which grow or submerge completely in the water. So in this way, today we'll learn about that fixed plant and underwater plants. Let's see the question answer on this portion, learning at home. The question ones, define fixed plant and write one adaptive feature. So you have to write the definition of fixed plant and one adaptive feature. And second, the same question, define underwater plants and give one adaptive feature. Okay, learn it and write it. Thank you.